you squares, it's time you smoked. Well, all right, you squares, it's time you smoked. Fire up this funk and let's have a toke. It'll make you dance with some of everything. Everybody get high.
Disc 6 form for 2 weeks now. So far, I haven't had any encounters with the school's bully, which is something I have experienced a lot at my previous educational facilities. Also, on the plus side, I've made some new friends.
One of the many study rooms at Disc 6 form. You'll be spending a lot of your time here outside of lesson, and it will be really important that you work to keep up with all your essays, and you can also work as a team and talk, which is different from the library. And if you don't keep up with all your essays, then you'll be in a lot of trouble with Mr. Buds, aka the Don.
You show me no respect. You don't offer friendship. You don't even think to call me the godfather. Instead, you come into my sixth form and you refuse to work. Okay. I will make you an offer. You can't refuse. You do all your assignments. You do all your coursework. You do all your homework. And maybe, we'll come to some sort of agreement. Okay? Okay, good. In the meantime, you will go to all the classes of my associates, or lessons, if you will. They will give you the knowledge that you need to make your way in the world. Now, use your time wisely, or you may live to regret it. Okay? Now get out of here.
The A-level course is much, it's harder, more demanding in every way possible. It always helps to have a genuine interest in the subject. That is the thing, because then it becomes much easier to learn it. I was a sixth former, 35 years ago. I just remembered, in my case, just having more independence. I was responsible for my own learning. Sixth form's halfway, a halfway house between the university, where you're getting no help at all, and of course, compulsory schooling in year 11 is where you're being told to do this, told to do that, hand this homework in. So what more could you want in the chemistry? You've got energy changes, you've got colour, you've got nice complex calculations, titrations.
Okay, there it is. Unknown carbon alcohol compound, right?
There are so many transferable skills that you learn from A-level science, and those are transferred into any and many areas of employment. So there are loads of reasons why you should do science at A level.
I'm playing to the camera now, aren't I? I'm playing to the camera. Right.
There are some similarities between the GCSE drama course and the A-level course, so if you've done drama before, it will be quite familiar to you. However, if you haven't done drama, you're not disadvantaged in any way. There is lots of elements of the course that are enjoyable and will be new experiences, such as our devising unit in year 13, where you take responsibility for directing and shaping your own work.
I love teaching all aspects of the A-level drama course, but my favourite part is in year 13, and it's the student devised piece. And I think this is a real opportunity for students to work on their own and actually put into practice everything that they've learnt in year 12.
My favourite part of the course is where we explore the various play texts that we study. And during that process, we get year 12 and 13 together and we bring theatre companies in to work with you. And that's always really exciting. And I love seeing the way that students incorporate their techniques into their own work. I think our ethos within our department is to prepare you for life after school as well. So we like to treat you like young adults. You are treated differently to the GCSE students that come through. We give you more responsibility. We like you to be workshop leaders and mentors to the younger students. So you're given lots of opportunities to develop skills outside of subject areas as well.
I can hear them laughing.
Should definitely take A-level drama because it's a fantastic subject in so many different ways, and it's not just for people who perhaps want to go on to do a drama degree or even to have a career in some kind of, you know, theatre practice. It's also just in terms of preparing you for life in general, so the kind of life skills that you learn in drama, particularly about working with other people, you don't really do very much on your own, so you have to learn to actually negotiate and to collaborate with other groups and other individuals, and not necessarily people who are in your friendship group or who you might naturally choose to be with, but you have to learn to get over that, and I think that that's a skill that actually sets you up for life in a very real way.
It is a really big cliche, but drama does give you confidence, and we've seen students' confidence grow over the course of the 2 years that they've been with us. The groups aren't huge, you get to know each other really well, you get to work together and negotiate together, and being in drama is like being a part of an extended family. You all look out for each other. So take drama, it's fab.
A-level geography is similar in some ways to GCSE geography in terms of its variety of topics. However, A-level geography is much more in depth. Geography as a subject is what you would call a multidisciplinary subject. So you do some sociology, some physical geography, some science, some maths, some history. All of those things combine to make geography, because geography is about the world. Geography in that case is really useful to lots of different types of people, depending on whether you want to go to university, or want to get a job, or want to go into college, or any career at all. Geography is going to be really useful to you because it has lots of different aspects. Go off to university and maybe study law after you've done geography, or you can go off to university and study oil geology. It doesn't matter really what you want to do, because geology will plug into most different subjects. Also, that freedom that you get, you know, you can obviously do a lot more around the school than you would be able to at GCSE level. But of course, that freedom you have to use responsibly, and if you do that, then you get loads out of it. My favourite part of the course is cake tube. No, it's not cake tube. My favourite part of the course is the field trip to Swanage in the autumn term. We go down to Swanage for 3 days, and we have a look at some coastal processes, and we have a look at Bournemouth, which, although it's not perhaps my most favourite place in the world, it is still an interesting place to go in terms of the geography that we study. Usually the weather is very pleasant at that time of the year, and the youth hostel meals are also very tasty.
Hey, I'm Christian, a student at DIS 6th form. Some places where you might want to go during breaks or frees is a common room. This common room here has a football table. I'm going to hand you over to Dom and Tom for today's commentary.
Yes, hello, welcome to today's game with me, Dom, and Tom, famous sports pundit. Well, there's the kickoff between England and Spain today at the famous DIS 6th form stadium. Absolutely wonderful stadium. Tom, what do you make of the stadium?
That's a lovely, lovely stadium, Dom. I mean, look at the way it's positioned at the moment, and the seats, there must be at least 2,000 seats in that stadium. It's just a beautiful, the way the lines are chalked out, I didn't even get a start on it. It's a beautiful stadium. I mean, the linesman who goes around and does that, you should be paid as much as the players. It's a beautiful job, it's a beautiful job.
Yeah, okay. What do you think of the team's lineup?
Ah, the lineup, it's amazing, isn't it? I mean, it must be something like a 2-4-3-1. Bloody cup of soup!
Let's take another replay of that here. Magnificent strike from Rooney, wasn't it? England 1-0 up now against Spain.
Oh.
Fantastic.
Is there a disabled toilet around there or something?
In the back of the net. Okay, Spain with the kickoff now. Let's see how Spain...
He's dirty play,
That's never good to see. Long range shot from Cavi, it's gone straight in.
Nah, not after that.
Absolutely nowhere near it.
I mean, do you see the way it bounces off? I think they need to get some goal line technology in here. Goal line technology.
England win the kickoff again.
Like goal line tech, like robots that can see where it comes in and stuff like that.
It's getting a bit scrappy.
A bit scrappy. I mean, I don't like it, but...
England with more
shots. Just offside.
Almost from Carroll. What do you think of England's midfield today?
Carroll is a beautiful player. Beautiful. I like his hair.
Carroll plays up front.
I know. I just win the midfield.
Torres on the edge. Hits it.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me, man. You've got to be kidding me.
That's got to be it now.
In the 90th minute as well.
The 90th minute?
Yeah.
I've got to go.
I think that sealed England's fate.
Sealed the deal.
2-1 in the 90th.
What is happening? I mean, he's lucky it was in the back of the net, because if it wasn't in the net, then it wouldn't have been a goal.
Okay, we've got an interview with the goalkeeper, Joe Hart, here. Joe, absolute howler from you today.
I like your hair, Joe. Are you aware you've let down England as a country, not as a team, as a country? Lost for words.
Shocking.
Shocking.
Absolutely
play.
Shocking.
Absolutely
let's
shocking.
Go on to the interview with Scott Parker now.
All right, Scotty boy. Now I've got a word with you as well. Your play in up front, was it?
Midfield.
In midfield, it was shocking. I mean, I don't understand how you can do that. Have you ever wondered why your name's different to all the other players' names. Like Parker, it's not a very footballing name. Nothing? Oh.
Okay, well, thanks very much, Scott. Me, Dom, and Tom here will be back in 2 years' time for England's next game. Until then, cheerio.
Bye.
Cheers, guys. The Bistro is a very popular place for the students. It's just sixth form. And the world round paninis are also very common in the hands of the students.
A-level art differs from GCSE art in the way that we are less prescribed. We give less suggestions and less direction and allow for the students' individual interests and motivations to take a centre role. We encourage independent thought and independent journeys through the course titles. With A-level, we would encourage people not only to look at the artist, but to look at maybe a gallery and choose an artist within in that gallery to then respond to off their own bat. My favourite part of the course has got to be the with A-level, it's got to be the way that we deliver galleries, because obviously as an artist and as a teacher, you draw from your own inspirations, you draw from the things that you feel strongest about. The differences with sixth form life in comparison to GCSE life: sixth formers obviously have free periods where GCSE students do not. So therefore their time is more their own. Therefore you work with A-level students in a different way. You can call them in on specific projects, like casting projects where, for example, somebody was casting their face this last year. So you allocate time within lunchtimes and free periods, as well as lessons, to do small or individual projects. The reason people should take art A-level, there's no such thing as should, but to find their own creativity, to find jobs which use creativity, is not so specific to becoming an artist. It's obviously a specific type of work, but it can be transferred into many different areas of the job market, with fashion, with design, with interiors, architecture, as well as the art and the sculpture and everything else. So I would encourage it on the basis of work ethic and the way that people are able to be examined at the end of it. It's very specific to that.
There's a big overlap between what we do at high level GCSE and what you start doing at A level. But as you go on in the course, the requirement to be very good at algebra becomes increasingly. that's probably the main. I really enjoyed pretty much all of it. There's some of the statistics topics that are quite fascinating. Vectors, I really enjoy teaching. And there's a lot of topics in the further maths, imaginary numbers, and topics where it gets weird and wonderful, I really enjoy. The main difference between life in the sixth form and lower down the school is I think that you're given a lot more freedom and expected to develop your own ways of studying. And where it's at all possible, teachers will treat sixth form students as adults. Taking maths at A level comes under two categories really. One is, I think maths is intrinsically fascinating, although I can understand that not everybody's going to agree with that. It's also a subject which has really high sale properties as far as employment and money goes. Students who take A level maths tend to find it very easy to get employment and well paid employment.
Okay, hi. It's different because there's a lot more detail in what we look at, and that makes it more interesting and exciting and fun. It's also much more collaborative, so you guys are left to do your own thing for vast quantities of time. The big coursework piece, which takes about 3 months, is basically you guys in groups making films, which is awesome, isn't it, Sergio? He's nodding, so it is. My favourite part of the course is, I don't know. I really like the whole course. I think it's an interesting course, but I guess it's probably when the coursework bits come together at the end and everybody's running around in here, in the media suite, trying to get everything done, and there's headphones and electricity everywhere and there's films all on the go and everybody's shouting at each other and shaking each other and being sort of angry and excited, and it's just a real sense of energy and it's nice and lively. The main differences between GCSE and sixth form life. You get to wear your own clothes, you get to play pool, you don't have to go into the lunch queue, you can go to the bistro and eat paninis, which is pretty much what most of you seem to do all the time. I guess there's more freedom. You can use your mobile phones, which must be important in some way, because you can, you know, Twitter each other at something vital. I don't know, is it better? Do you think it's better?
Yeah.
Yeah? Really? I think it's freedom, isn't it? It's just a sense of, you know, you're adults now and you've got more responsibility and, you know, there's less of you as well. And you're all smart, which is important. I guess, no, don't touch the camera, Sergio. I guess, GCSE is a lot of you guys sitting around in a classroom, listening to a teacher talk for an hour, and then, you know, doing some writing, drawing a picture and stuff. Whereas A-level is a lot more about you guys working in groups together, discussing stuff, coming up with your own ideas. And there's a lot of stuff about you going outside with cameras and sound recording equipment and, you know, headphones and tripods and weird stuff attached to skateboards and making films, which is, you know, more exciting, right? Next question. Degree-wise, there's a lot of options if you take a subject like media, for example. You can do a degree which is fairly hands-on, camera stuff, costume design, set design. You can go into journalism, you can work towards TV. I mean, degree-wise, it's very good. You need to stand out. This is a subject which will allow you to stand out. Plus, it's awesome. They're nodding! They are nodding.
English A-level differs to GCSE English because you just get to study a lot more exciting texts. You get to learn loads of new terminology and sound much more brainy than all the rest of the people in your year group. And there's just basically much more choice in texts. You get to have a couple of teachers and you get to discuss things that you're actually interested in. Actually, it's really hard to say the favourite part of my A-level course that I teach with the English Lang Lit, because it's all fantastic. There's a great range of texts. Students talk and seem to really give a personal response to everything they do. You get to study a variety of texts, as well as spoken language as well, which is always quite entertaining to think about the ways in which people talk to each other, as well as the way in which they write it down on paper. And the differences between A-level life and GCSE life are really this fact that teachers have a lot more trust in you. There's no more or less write your homework down in your homework diary. It's your choice as to whether you make notes, as to whether you stick to deadlines. But I think consequently, students become so much more independent that they actually talk to their teachers, and these things just all seem to slip naturally into place. This is a great relationship between staff, students and within the sixth form as a whole. I think that all students who study English, because it's just such a fantastic base for any university course, it turns you into a quality reader, you advance your vocabulary choices, you learn how to express yourselves far much more successfully than you do as purely a GCSE student. It's just a really great basis for future study as well, because you can go on to do lots of postgraduate courses, such as doing your law conversion, your teacher training. Really opens lots of doors for you in the future.
If you want to take a break from studying, we have a pool table room. Sometimes it can get quite serious.